स्टूडेंट्स, हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय वीडियो लेक्चर क्लासेस ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग डिप्लोमा एंड बीटेक। हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम देवाशीष दास, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, ग्रेटर कोलकाता कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर और वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ बीटेक एंड डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग। It will be a great session for all of you. So please be with us. In this video, we are going to study about the different topics of analog electronics and its applications, how the analog electronics apply in our different fields of electronics. In this video, we are going to study about it, different circuits and its part. We are explaining one by one in this topic. Hello everyone, welcome to another sessions of analog electronics. In these sessions, we are going to discuss about the energy band and the classifications of material. First, we introduce something and of the energy band, what is energy band is. Then we'll discuss about the different types of energy band for different materials. So let's start. In the introduction part, we'll discuss about the energy band. We take a atom of silicon, which is consist of 14 electrons in its outer shell of the atom, and in the last orbit of the silicon there is 4 electrons present. That is why the valency of the silicon is 4. Electrons present in the outermost orbit is called the valency of the atom, and the behavior decided and electrical characteristics of the material depend upon this valency. So for silicon, 2 electrons are present in the 3s and 2 electrons are present in 3p orbit. Consider an silicon atom which are apart from each other, so the interactions between them is very negligible. In this 2n electron occupies 3s level and 2n electrons in 3p level. When the atoms are brought closer, the interactions between increases and then now form a electronic system. The electronic system should obey the Pauli's exclusion principle, which states that the 2 electrons are in the systems cannot have same amount of energy. That means the 2 electron never have the same amount of energy. So to obey this, 3s and 3p level split it into multiple levels, so that each electron occupy a distinct energy level. That means each electron should be unique energy level. When interatomic distance is further reduced, the 2ns level and 6np levels combined into a single band. That means the for s the capacity of electrons is 2 and for p the capacity of electrons is 6. These two levels combine and form a single band. At lattice spacing, single band is split into two bands with upper band conducting and 4n lower band with 4n levels. That means it's split into two bands. Upper band can occupy 4 electrons and lower band also can occupy 4 electrons. At 0 degree Kelvin, electron passes lower energy, so they fill up valence band and conduction band is remaining empty. This is very important point. In 0 degree Kelvin or 0 degree K, all the electrons should present in the valence band. It is for the silicon atom. You can see a diagram how the bands form. If the atomic distance changes, the bands combine in, and in this way the conduction band and valence band is being created. You can see over there, this is the conduction band and it is a valence band, and this is a energy versus atomic distance graph. In this graph we can see very carefully that how the conduction band and the valence band is being created. In this between two bands, Eg is the band gap. Band gap is nothing but the difference between the conduction band and the valence band. So we'll discuss this about more deeply. The valence band of the energy level which are closer to nucleus, and electron in valence band experience a stronger force attraction from the nucleus, and it move freely when external energy field is applied. It is called the bounded electron. So this is all about the valence band. Valence band is the most stronger band than the conduction band, as it is closer to the nucleus and most of electrons are present in this valence band. The forbidden energy gap or the energy gap, it is the in the solid state physics, an energy gap or the band gap is an energy range in a solid where no electron states can exist. That means in this forbidden energy gap there should be no electron energy state. In generally refers to the energy difference between the top valence band and the bottom of the conduction band in the insulator and semiconductor. We'll see in upcoming pictures. This should be very important points for the energy band gaps. In a solid material, the electron energy level forms of allowed energies separated by a forbidden energy bands. The valence band is the outermost highest band filled with electrons, and conduction band is the next higher band to the valence band. It's maybe partially or empty filled. Band gap is the energy difference between the valence band and the conduction band, which is also a forbidden band. Points we should remember for this understanding: electrons in the completely filled band cannot move since all states occupied, as the Pauli's exclusion principle. Only way to move would be to jump into a next higher band, and it's required energy. So to require or to jump a electron from the valence band to the conduction band, there should be requirement of energy. Electrons in the partly filled band can move since there are three states to move. Now, so far we have discussed about the different bands. We will just take a animations video about this energy bands. What is the valence band, conduction band and forbidden energy? We just take an animation of it. Just take a look.
Let us know about the valence band, conduction band and forbidden energy gap. The electrons in inner shells are strongly bound to the nucleus. A band which is occupied by the valence electrons or a band having highest energy is defined as a valence band. The valence band may be partially or completely filled. This band can never be empty. In some materials, the valence electrons are loosely attached to the nucleus. Even at room temperature, some of the valence electrons can leave the valence band. These are called as free electrons. They are responsible for conduction of current in a conductor and are henceforth called as conduction electrons. The band occupied by these electrons is called a conduction band. This band may be an empty band or partially filled band. The separation between valence band and conduction band is known as forbidden energy gap. If an electron is to be transferred from valence band to conduction band, external energy is required, which is equal to the forbidden energy gap.
We have seen this video. We can just make understanding of valence band, conduction band and forbidden energy gap. Now we move with the different types of material. In these sections, we just divided the three types of material: insulator, conductor and semiconductor, depend upon its electrical characteristics in nature. We divide the three types of material. We divide it into three types of material depend upon the electrical characteristics. First, insulator, conductor and semiconductor. First, we discuss about the insulator. Let's see what is insulator is. Before going to that, we are just take a look about the band gap or the band gap difference between the conduction band and the valence band of different material. You can see for the conductor, it is the conductor. You can see over there the conduction band and the valence band are overlapped. For semiconductor, there is a slight separations between the conduction band and the valence band, and for insulator, the band gap is much more, or it is the highest for the conduction band and the valence band. So this is the difference between a conductor, semiconductor and insulator depend upon the band gap. The band gap or the it is the energy gap or the energy difference is nothing but the kinds of energy, and it is the unit of this energy gap or the band gap or the energy is known as electron volt. You can abbreviate it as EV. Now we also know that joule is also a unit of energy, but for joule is a very large for dealing with electrons, atoms and nucleus. That is why we just write it EV for our abbreviation. It is known as electron volt, and the relations between this electron volt and joule can be stated like this. Electron volt is a energy required to move one electron through a potential difference of 1 volt. So 1 eV equal to Q into V. We know the charge of an electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb or C and 1 volt. And we just simplify it, we can get 1 eV equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. This is the relations between the electron volt and joule. Both are the unit of energy. Now we just move into our first inductor, insulator, sorry. It is the insulator. It is a material which has a large energy band gap. Eg's energy gap is for several eV, and we have seen these relations, eV equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power 9 minus 19 joule, which is the relations between a electron volt and joule. Due to the large energy band gap, an electron from valence band cannot move into the conduction band, remain completely filled. Conduction band completely empty. Examples of these insulators are glass, diamond, silicon dioxide, etc. The energy band gap of the diamond is in the order of 6 electron volt, which is very large to jump an electron from the valence band to the conduction band. Now we come to the conductor. Conductor is a material having a zero energy overlap. That means the energy valence band and the conduction band overlap to each other. Valence electron can move valence band to conduction band without require any thermal energy. The overlapping indicates a large number of electrons available for the conduction band for the conduction. Hence, the applications of a small amount of voltage result a large amount of current. Example, all types of metal like silver is the best and the copper is the second best, and there are lots many. These are the few examples of, or we can say there are 5 examples of a conductor and some insulators. You can see a silver, gold, copper, steel, sea waves, that is means salt water is also a conductor. And on the other hand, we can see a rubber, glass, oil, diamond, glass wood, they are all insulator. These are the example of conductor and insulator. There is another element known as semiconductor. In material in which the conduction and valence bands are separated by a small energy gap in the order of 1 electron volt are called the semiconductor. Silicon and germanium are the commonly used semiconductor. A small energy gap means that a small amount of energy is required to free electrons by moving them from the valence band into the conduction band. The semiconductor behaves like an insulator at 0 degree Kelvin because no electrons are available in the conduction band, because all the electrons are present in the valence band for the 0 degree Kelvin. If the temperature is further increased, more valence and electron will acquire energy to jump into the conduction band. If valence required receive sufficient thermal energy, it can move into the conduction band, leaving a vacancy in the valence band, which is called the hole. This vacancy of electron is called the hole. Therefore, if one electron is sufficiently thermally energized, it creates a pair of free electron and hole. This process is called the carrier generation. The carrier generations can happen due to thermal excitation, फोटो एक्साइटेशन, इलेक्ट्रिकल एक्साइटेशन एंड इम्पैक्ट आयनाइजेशंस। विल सी हाउ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड होल पेयर आर क्रिएटेड इन आवर कमिंग स्लाइड एंड हाउ द कंडक्टिविटी चेंजेस ड्यू टू दिस कैरियर जेनरेशन इन द सेमीकंडक्टर। विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस फेनोमिना इन दिस पिक्चर। This is the energy, which is the external energy. It may be a heat, electric field, or photo effect. Anything can be happen. This is the external energy which came into the semiconductor, and it's directly attack the valence band, which produce the free electron from the, and this electron jumps from the valence band to conduction band. This required to jumping from the valence band to conduction band requires some energy. That energy is being supplied by this external energy sources. More the energy, external energy, more will be a electron shipment from the valence band to conduction band. We can see when an electron is jumping from the valence band or move from the valence band to conduction band, a vacancy of electron, you can see a vacancy of electron is being created in the valence band. This vacancy of electron is called the hole, or it is positively charged. And the electron which move into the conduction band, now it can take part in the electrical property, or it can produce current, or help to flow the current or electron flow. Now it can take part in the electrical conductivity. So more the energy, more the electron and hole pair. It is called the electron and hole pair. One electron is, if the electron is there in the conduction band, there should be a hole in the conduction valence band. So there will be a electron and hole pair will be generated. In the conduction band, the electron is there, and the valence band, a hole is there, should present. So, electron and hole pair should be generated in the semiconductor due to the presence of the external energy. When the room temperature is 0 degree Kelvin, or when we make this temperature 0 degree Kelvin, so there will be no external energy, and all the electron and hole pair will not present. All the electrons should present in the valence band, and there will be no free electron in the conduction band for the 0 degree Kelvin temperature. And at that time, the insulator act like a, sorry, at that time the semiconductor act like a pure insulator for 0 degree Kelvin. In this way, our insulator take part in the electrical characteristics. So there is the energy gap of a silicon, it is 1.2, and for the germanium it is 0.785. When an external electric field is applied, the free electrons travels with conduction band producing electrical current, whereas a hole travels in the valence produce the hole current. The total current will be sum of the free hole and free electrons. So the I total, this is the very important equations. The I total is produced for the free electron and free holes. So as the temperature increase, the free electron and hole will increase, and the current is also going to increase. So the conductivity is also going to increase for the semiconductor. So it is a positive temperature coefficient in nature. The semiconductor is the positive temperature coefficient in the nature. That means the conductivity increases the with the help of temperature. As the temperature increase, more the electron and hole pair also generated, and it take part in the conductivity, and the current also increases. So the conductivity is also increases. It's a very important property of a semiconductor. You can see in this picture there is another important thing: the amount of hole and the amount of free electron will be the same for a semiconductor, pure semiconductor. For a pure semiconductor, the amount of electron, because all the electrons present in the conduction band, there should be a vacancy in the valence band. So the vacancy in the valence band is called the hole, and the presence of the electron in the conduction band is known as the free electron. So number of free electron and the number of hole should be same for a semiconductor, pure semiconductor. So in this way, in this picture, we can realize how the current flow happens. It is the conventional current in the external circuits. It's a battery is there, plus terminal and minus terminal is there, and the electrons is being attracted of a semiconductor towards the positive terminal of the battery, and the holes are, as the holes are the positive charge and electrons are the negative charge, that is why the electrons are attracted towards the positive terminal of the battery, and the hole, as a being a positive charge, is attracted towards the negative terminal of the battery. And this way, in this way, the electron and current, electron and the hole, combination of these two produce the current flow in the semiconductor. And as we know, the conventional current is always flow from the positive terminal of the battery towards the negative terminal of the battery. So the way move the hole is the direction of the current flow, and the electron flow is in the opposite direction of the current flow. So the hole flow is in towards the direction of the conventional current flow, and the electron flow towards the negative direction of the, or the inverse direction of the conventional current flow. So in this way, the current flow takes place for a semiconductor. Now we see how a metal insulator and semiconductor and their band gaps will affect with the help of a animation. Let us see.
Let us know the energy levels of insulators, semiconductors and conductors. Insulators. In an insulator, the forbidden energy gap is very large. In general, the forbidden energy gap is more than 3 electron volts, and almost no electrons are available for conduction. Therefore, a very large amount of energy must be supplied to a valence electron to enable it to move to the conduction band. In case of materials like glass, the valence band is completely filled at 0 Kelvin. The energy gap between the valence band and conduction band is of the order of 10 electron volts. Even in the presence of high electric field, the electrons cannot move from valence band to conduction band. If the electron is supplied with high energy, it can jump across the forbidden gap. When the temperature is increased, some electrons will move to the conduction band. This is the reason why certain materials which are insulators at room temperature become conductors at high temperature. The resistivity of insulator approximately lies between 10 raised to 11 and 10 raised to 16 ohm meter. Semiconductors. In semiconductors, the forbidden gap is very small. Germanium and silicon are the best examples of semiconductors. The forbidden gap energy is of the order of 0.7 electron volts for germanium and 1.1 electron volt for silicon. There are no electrons in the conduction band. The valence band is completely filled at 0 Kelvin. With a small amount of energy that is supplied, the electrons can easily jump from the valence band to the conduction band. For example, if the temperature is raised, the forbidden gap is decreased and some electrons are liberated into the conduction band. The conductivity of a semiconductor is of the order 10 raised to 2 mho per meter. Conductors. In conductors, there is no forbidden gap available. The valence band and conduction band overlap each other. The electrons from valence band freely enter into the conduction band. Due to the overlapping of the valence and conduction bands, a very low potential difference can cause the continuous flow of current.
So we have seen how the metal insulator and semiconductor and their band gap changes, and the conductivity and their property get changes. Now just take a difference between a conductor insulator and the semiconductor. You can see a difference chart for the conductor insulator and semiconductor. The conductivity of the conductor is very high. The conductivity of an insulator is very low, and the conductivity of a semiconductor is moderate. It has low resistivity for the conductor, it has very high resistivity for the insulator, and it has moderate resistivity for the semiconductor. You can see from this chart, for the conductor it has the no forbidden energy gap, which we have seen in this previous slides and video also. It has a large forbidden energy gap for the insulator, and for the semiconductor it has small forbidden energy gap. You can see in the chart there are lots of differences. The examples of conductor is metals, aluminium, copper, etc., and the insulator it is the mica, glass, etc., and for the semiconductor it is silicon, germanium. There are lots of many, but these are two examples of for the semiconductor. You can see the difference between the conductor insulator and semiconductor. Here is some band gap differences between the conduction band and the valence band of a metal or the material are there. For silicon, the band gap is 1.1 electron volt EV. They are all order in electron volt. We have seen the band gap. So these are some chart you can see. It is a silicon, germanium, they are all semiconductor material. You can see the diamond is there, which is a good insulator, and we can see a copper dioxide, copper oxide is there. So this is the chart of a different material having different energy band gaps. So in this way we conclude this session. Thank you for watching. If you have any queries, you can contact to me. The contact number is given. The same number can be used as WhatsApp number. If you have any queries or doubt, you can
call me or WhatsApp me to this number. Thank you very much.